Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel Economics Classes. On the channel I teach economics. Today I'll be teaching class 9 chapter 1, the story of Phyllis Palampo. Before starting the class, I would like to give you a brief introduction about myself. I am Sunidhi Arya. I have done graduation in economics from Crodimal College, TU, and right now I'm pursuing masters in economics. So before starting the class, I would like to give you a brief overview what all we are going to study in this class. So in the earlier class, in the part one of the video, I have taught you the two very important concepts of production and farming. Now we will continue the discussion. So if you haven't watched the part one, I would suggest you to watch that part first and then come back later so that you can understand the chapter totality. You can have a better clarity once you have watched that video as well. So in that video, I told you about the production process, factors of production, and about the farm activities, how is farming is being done in a rural area. So I told you that there are four factors of production: land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship. So in today's class, we will see that how land, labor, capital is being arranged in the village Palampur and what all are the non-farm activities which we see in the village Palampur. We need to understand how is the land distribution is in the village Palampur. As I have told you earlier, that land is a fixed resource. We cannot increase the quantity. So we need to see how much land a person owns in a village. So when we talk about the land distribution, we means how is the land distributed between the population of an area. When we talk about the village Palampur, as I've told you earlier, that scheduled caste family, which was one third of the population, they are landless. They do not own any land and they do work on some other people farms as a farm laborers to earn their wages. Apart from that, there are 240 families which are small and marginal farmers. What is small and marginal farmers? According to the government of India, any farmer who owns less than 2 hectares of a land is small and marginal farmer, and anyone who owns more than 2 hectares of a land is in large farmers. So 240 families are the small and marginal farmers, and 60 families are such who hold more than 2 hectares of the lands, and there are very very few farmers who owns more than 10 hectares of a land. So we can see that land distribution is very very unequal. Few people have more land, and the majority of people, either they do not have land, and if they do have land, then they have very very less amount of land available to them. Now we'll study that how the labor is being arranged in the village Palampur. As we all know that farming is a very tedious job. It takes very very huge amount of labor and hard work to produce a crop. So in producing the crop, the labor is provided in two different ways. As I told you earlier, there are two kind of people who produces the crops: farmers and farm laborers. Farmers are two types: small farmers are those farmers who owns less than 2 hectares of the land, and on the 2 hectares of a land, it is a very small quantity, so they do not hire any laborer from the market. So they arrange by themselves. Entire family of the village work on a particular farm. Like there is a family of 5 members. Suppose 3 are in the working age. So all 3 of them do work on a plot of land. So they do not need to hire the labor from the outside. There are large farmers who owns very large amount of land, and it is almost possible to produce crops by themselves or with the help of family. So they do hire farm laborers. Farm laborers are the people who do not own any land, and they do work on the basis of the wages. These wages may be in cash or kind. Sometimes they get food also, Wages do differ on the very basis. It from region to region. Region to region means in North India, farm laborers do have different wages, and in South India, they do have different wages. From season to season, like sowing season and harvesting season, and from crop to crop. The crop which has a higher yield and higher market prospects and which is highly commercialized gets more wages. I hope you all have understood that how a labor is being arranged in the village Palampur. There is a small story of farmer Dala. As we all know that government has decided the minimum wage rate where the employer need to pay a minimum wage rate to the farmers. So minimum wage rate set by the government is 175 per day, but Dala works almost approximately for the 80 rupees per day. Because there is so much of competition to get a work and proper amount of work is not available, so they do work even the less wage. Now we need to see that how the capital is being arranged in the village Palampur. As I have told you that capital is any kind of fixed investment or day-to-day working requirements, yeah, day-to-day money requirement we need to run a business. So capital is arranged by the two ways, medium farmers and small farmers. Since their yield is not so much high, they do have a small plot available for the farming, so borrow the money. From where do they borrow the money? They borrow from the money lenders, traders. Traders are the persons who trades in the agriculture related commodities like seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, manure. So what small farmers do, that they do get the all the inputs on the credit, and once harvesting is done, they do pay the entire amount of money with the interest. There is a small story in your textbook which is of a Savita. Savita is a lady who is a farmer and who wants to produce on the crop, and when she is producing, there are some constraint. She doesn't have the working capital. She needs to buy for the seeds, fertilizers, manures and pesticides, and apart from that she needs some machinery repairment. And when she wants to calculate, and when she calculates, it amounts up to the 3,000 rupees. So she needs 3,000 rupees to produce a crop. Since she doesn't have a source of income, she went to the other farmers. Farmer's name is Tejpal, and he gave her the credit at a very high rate of interest, which is 24%. And apart from that, she also has to make promise that she will work on his field when harvesting season will come. The crop puri tayar ho jayegi aur jab uske kaatne ka time aayega, then she will work on it at the rate of 35 rupees per day. As you can see, the interest rate is very high and wages she is going to get is 35 per day. Still, she has agreed with all these two conditions to get the 3000 rupees, because if she doesn't get these 3000 rupees, she won't be able to produce anything. Now let's talk about how the large farmers produces the capital. Large farmers have the more amount of land available to them. They own more than 10 acres of land in some cases. So they do have a huge output available with them. From this huge output, they keep themselves for the family, for the subsistence. And apart from that, whatever is left, they do sell it in the market. And from market, they do get the money. Once they do get the money, they keep a small portion of it as a saving. And from this saving, they do give loan to the people, and they do all buy the farm machineries and equipments which are required for the purpose of worker capital. So that is how capital is being arranged. I have told you the two different concepts: labor, how do we arrange the labor, how does the small farmers manages the labor, large farmers manages the labor, and how capital is being managed in the small farms and the large farms. Since I have told you everything about this, now we need to see what are the non-farm activities in the Palampur. I have told you in the demography in the part one that there are only 75% people are engaged in the farming activities. In the non-farm activities, 25% of the people are engaged. And these 25% people are engaged in these four kind of work. First, we need to understand the dairy. The dairy is being explained in your textbook through the example that, as I have told you earlier, that in the kharif season, we sow jowar and bajra for the cattle field of farmers. Farmers sell the milk and the milk products fields to the market in the nearby village and the small town Chahapur, which has some chilling center. In the chilling center, milk sustained for a longer period of time. So they do go in the small town and they do sell their product. There is a small scale manufacturing. Manufacturing in village is not done at the very large level as we have seen in the towns and the cities. It is done at a very, very basic level. So it is explained through the help of the Mishri Lal. Mishri Lal is a person who owns a small manufacturing center, and on this he produces the jaggery. Good कहते हैं जिसे हिंदी में जैगरी, जैगरी पाउडर. So what he does, that all the labor on this production activity is being organized by the family or family members. As in the farming, entire family used to work on a single plot of land to get the produce. On the same way, in this small scale manufacturing, entire family works to get a product. What does Mr. Lal produce and how does it do? He owns a mechanical sugarcane crushing machine. And he crushes the sugar cane and he produces the goods like jaggery and jaggery powder. And this is known as kolhu in Hindi. Earlier, it was used to done with the bullocks. Bullocks hote the, bal hote the, jinko hum kolhu mein chalate the. And they used to produce the jaggery and jaggery powder. But now it all has been electrified. We use the electricity to this small scale manufacturing. I have told you earlier that because of electricity, we are able to do the irrigation and small scale manufacturing better. Now, apart from these two, there is one other, the shop keeper's son who purchases the goods from the city and sell it to the people of the village. And these goods mainly includes the grocery items, rice, wheat, toothpaste, tea, the daily necessity items which we require in our day-to-day business, and mostly eatable items. Kareem is a person who owns a computer class. Kareem is the person who once saw that people from this village goes to the Shahapur and nearby small town to earn the computer computers. And when he saw this and he has a knowledge of computer, he opened a shop in the market. He hires two more ladies who has a certain qualification in computers, and he started a coaching center. After a point of time, his coaching center was doing really well. So this is how economy works in a rural area. Transport. Kishora was a farm laborer who earlier used to work on a farm, and he used to get daily 40 rupees per day, 50 rupees per day. And that was a very, very minimum and less amount of income which was available to him. So he applied for a loan. He got the loan sanctioned, and from the loan, he purchased a buffalo. He used to get milk from the buffalo, and he used to sell that milk in the dairy and to the other villages. And apart from that, he used that bullock as a transport, bullock cart. And once a month, he used to go to the near river Ganga, from where he used to bring clay to the porter. So you can see how everything is interlinked in an economy. Everything is interlinked in an economy, and there is a symbiotic relationship. Like transportation is increasing day by day, and as I have told you earlier, that good transport is a part of the best infrastructure of the country, and infrastructure is needed for the development of the country. If you don't have proper infrastructure, there won't be development of any country. I hope this chapter would be clear to you, and if you still have any doubt, please let me know in the comment section. I would reply that. If you are liking the video, please like it, share it with your friends, and subscribe to the channel. And make sure after subscribing, you hit the notification so that whenever I upload the chapter 2 of Economics, People as a Resource, you get an instant notification to that. So like, share, and subscribe. And thank you very much.